of school?
Yes.
Malting? Nerves?
And nerves.
And a crush on Mr. Archibald.
Did you hear that?
I did. I wouldn't believe it, but it was very...
Not true.
I just want to put the
not
camera
true.
Down.
Not true at all. Actually, it was Mr. Erskine.
Mr. Erskine? Do you know?
Everyone had a crush on
Mr. Erskine. Is now the deputy of Barrow High.
Roland Van Til, actually. I do. He was a very good friend of mine, and I wish he was here tonight, but I believe he's in Paris. Yeah, very appropriate place to be. Yeah.
Bonjour!
I can imagine Roland in Paris. Bonjour, Roland! Or something in German, Guten Tag.
She's a broad educated person. Wow.
In Swedish, perhaps.
That's right.
A
word from your sister.
Well, I don't know. I don't really know what I'm doing here. You get all these funny people who look at you and try and remember who you are or where you fit into their year and not realising that you're 5 years older than the rest of them. So, but it's a good night, yeah, seeing some people that I haven't seen since primary school, probably.
Listen, just back to Marion.
Marion.
Marion, should I say. Yeah. One of the things that you always treasure, that you have in your keepsakes, it's an award, apparently, isn't it, from a teacher? A special essay?
Most unique essay?
Yes.
With my name, the date, and my signature.
How about
that? Mr. Archibald. Memories of school, lonely corridors, nasty people,
right.
And pink rat's tail.
Pink rat's tail.
Pink rat's tail. Which my maths teacher said, get that off in my classroom. I said, sorry, I can't.
That wouldn't have been Mr. Fishburne, would it?
Oh my God. It probably was. The Fishburne. Disciplinary master of all time.
Oh yeah, with the onion breath. Blimey. That would discipline a person for about 10 metres.
Yeah, this is all true. Unfortunately true. Yeah.
He was our form master, actually.
Oh my God.
He ruined our Year 10 farewell. We had a choice. We could have tea and scones in room 16, 17 and 18 or nothing. So guess what we chose?
Nothing.
We were the only year to not have a Year 10 farewell.
Oh, tell me, man.
So you're looking forward to a good night? Good night tonight?
Rum and Coke.
Move on and find out what happened to others around the place.
Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure.
Okay, one of the
Yes, right. Megan Payne, I helped, and so did Jeff Deacon.
Yep.
Karen Lovell, who did not make it through school but was still a big help. And I think that's all. Oh, and Michael Hall, who's going to be our MC. But he's going to hold hands with Howie and his job. And all together we're doing that. And Jeff Deacon's band is going to play. And
is that the band is still together? Is it the original format?
No. Jeff Deacon with Darren Bretherton and nobody else out of our
band.
Yes.
So we're looking forward to that.
And that's all I know about the evening.
Okay.
Other than that, we're going to get really drunk.
Still talking.
Oh, hi there. How are you, Dennis?
Good day, Anna.
Long time,
mate. Yeah, so, listen, mate, still in the line going ever upward with Woolies or Coles? No, given a
coal miner.
Coal miner now?
Coal miner.
Coal miner?
Coal miner.
Gee whiz. How long do you stay with Coles, mate?
7 years with Coles,
yeah. And
I've been 3.5, 4 years in the mines.
That's it. And you haven't looked back?
Mines is the best thing that happened to me.
That's it. What, it's just purebred money coming
in? Well, yeah, you print your own out there.
Do you really?
The job sucks, but the money's too good to leave.
Right. So, whereabouts is this? Is it
No, back of Warragamba Dam, Burragreen Valley.
All right.
So, I enjoy it.
Yeah.
And, got me a house and got me a wife and a young bloke, doing well.
You set yourself up?
Set up.
Yeah. Well, do you live up there at Warragamba?
No, well, I live at Narellan. It is nice, yeah, new estate there. So, all young people living in the area, it's real good.
Okay. What are your best memories of school?
My mates. Yeah.
Who's here tonight that's hanging out?
Nearly every one of them. Very surprised at who they could find. And,
well, surprised that they're still alive.
Well,
who's here?
40?
40, yeah. Well, 40.
Well, we'll go through the, yeah, 40.
The nicknames. We've got 40,
yeah.
Zest, Panda.
Who's that?
Panda.
Panda. Yeah, smile for the camera.
No. She's not married yet?
Yeah, she's married.
Six kids.
Whatever, mate.
Everyone remember Richard Butter?
Everyone would have forgotten by now. Absolutely. Yeah.
Richard, what would you like to say on your formal video?
On a formal video?
Who's
the video going to?
Well, everyone in the form and in a work on it, really.
What I'd actually like to do here, Dennis, is...
Yes. Give me one of your cards.
If anybody would like any property for sale in Sydney, in the city centre in North Sydney, I want you to give me a call.
Hang on,
there it is.
I'll put it still on that. Hang on, wait. Just get the focus on that.
Thank you.
Here we go.
And I don't know what the title actually means, but I know what my job is.
Yeah. You ruined this beer, mate.
Sorry, Dan.
It's all right.
I'm so sorry, mate. Well, do you remember that game that we played up in A Block? You went for Mario. And you absolutely... What about the ball?
It was totally uncalled for.
Yeah. He provoked you.
I was down on my hands and knees. Billy Harrigan did a slam dunk off me back.
Billy Harrigan? Yeah. Bill?
No, he's not here.
He's not here, right.
Then I pulled Mario's shorts down. He threw the ball, hit me in the back of the head. So then I had to go at Mario.
Did you?
Yes.
I can't believe that.
That
seems to be a one-sided story.
That was the typical tootus at Barry White.
Is he coming in?
Still a big wog,
really?
No? We love Mario.
He's good, right? You love Mario?
I love
Well, actually, well, maybe I shouldn't go into this.
Do you remember John Holmes, Dennis?
John Holmes.
Bend over.
That's Phil Mahara.
John Holmes. Bend over.
That's
40.
Big 40.
I don't know.
It's
big 40. What about the end there, Dennis?
What's that guy with the earring?
Dennis.
What sort of guy wears an earring?
That's a chook feeder. He's a chook feeder.
Chook feeder, is he?
He's in the BHCF club.
Sure
he
is. Who is he?
Big Howie.
Howie?
Philip
Howie.
Oh, right. With you. So outrageous at some stage of his career.
Oh, mate, everything. Just coming to school.
Just what he was.
Ask Hawley about Libby Hinton.
I don't know Libby. You're a chef.
All right, so who else is on the table? Point out some other faces.
Philip Wales.
Philip Wales. Adam.
Vickery.
Yeah.
Adam Vickery, right now. Yeah.
Stephen Ford, Matthew Iannelli. Just you.
Just you.
The big Stewie.
What have you done with yourself, John?
Mate, I live with my grandmother.
Do you?
Yeah.
So you're on pension?
I do tapestry.
Oh, really?
I do.
You do tapestry?
Are you a corporate manager?
Get out of here.
I work for ICM Motors in management on ICM Motors, but I do tapestry and I live with my grandmother. I was married, divorced.
Already?
Yeah.
One fell swoop.
Yeah.
Any kids?
17.
17?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. I did that in 5 years, so...
And he still has the tag of stove, doesn't he?
He's new reconstructed.
New reconstruction.
Yeah. So he's still silly enough to play football.
I haven't.
Did that happen through basketball?
I haven't for 2 years.
Yeah.
But I will play again.
And is this your good business going to wedding?
This is my lovely girlfriend, Megan Blouse, from Queanbeyan.
Lovely part of the world.
Yeah.
So, what are you doing down to Queanbeyan? You work in Canberra, do you?
No, I work in Mossvale.
And
Megan comes from Queanbeyan.
Yeah.
And we see each other on weekends.
Fair enough. Sort of meeting Golden,
do you? No, I go up there every weekend.
Yeah. And the men come to me.
Fair enough.
And Mum lives up there, and I've got two brothers up there.
Right,
Dennis, good.
Any memory that you have apart from that Barrow Boys sort of incident? Probably give myself. except 100 of them.
Of what? No, just well, if you give me time, I'll think of a beauty.
Well,
alright.
Catch me at some stage.
I will.
Ask me about a teacher that's still there. Any teacher that you...
Alf Manwaring?
Yeah, he's Manwaring just about ready to retire. Okay, retires this year.
Miss Cheek?
Here's another one.
Miss Cheek?
Miss Cheek has gone.
Miss Cheek.
Gone by about 10 years.
No.
But Buzzard has retired. Can you believe that?
Oh, Miss Smith.
Yep.
Miss Buzzard?
Yes.
Buzzard's gone.
She's gone. The school's going to fall over. She's retired.
This won't
the old librarian.
Buzzard has retired.
Buzzard has retired.
Yeah. You know,
the nose. We've got a new library and a new librarian.
I remember the time.
Yeah. Here we go.
We had Stan Dawes as a deputy principal.
Yeah.
He lined a lot of us up and trained us for fighting.
How many?
It's about 10.
What was the occasion?
Yeah.
Fighting, wasn't it?
Yeah, so, I wasn't fighting or tech drawing, mate. We were chucking rubbers up in the vans.
Yeah.
That's right.
So, Stan Dawes had his toilet right next to the deputy principal office, and he had to get into it with a key.
Yeah.
So I got sent out of Miss Cheek's English class to go and see him one day.
Yeah.
And I could see the key in the toilet, and I knew he was in there.
Yeah.
So I locked her up, and I slipped the key back underneath the door.
Stan Dawes? Yeah. He's the manager.
And then the day Stan Dawes left, he said to me, he said, I know you did it.
Yeah.
He said, all I want you to do is admit it. And I said, yes, Stan, I did. And he said, right, up in your office and give me 6.
Thanks, mate. Thank you for the memory. G'day, g'day, g'day.
Good to be coming, eh? That's got a good idea.
What am I doing?
That's a good idea.
This is a good idea.
Yes.
Is this the Mrs.?
Yes.
Hello. Family name, sort of.
Luke.
That's right. And this is Graham, is it?
No.
Paul. Was there a Graham somewhere along the line? Sorry to do that to you, Paul.
No, that's all right. The older brother.
Older brother.
Yeah.
Right. Well, we had a few of the Lukes through, didn't we?
Oh, you did. Yeah, you had Sylvia.
Yeah.
My sister Gay.
Yeah. Right.
We've got a few more to come yet.
A few more to come?
Yeah.
I can see that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I wasn't counting that one, but there's more still.
There's still.
Yeah.
You're still in the area, or are you out?
Still in the area. Living in Beaumont at the moment.
Right. And what are you doing with yourself?
Well, I work as a storeman.
Right.
At Mossvale, Joy.
A job that you don't count as a permanent arrangement with Joy?
Oh, I've had them for the last 5 years.
Oh, well, that's...
Storeman, but I got me trained as a mechanic, so there's something to fall back on.
What are your memories of school? Good or bad, or indifferent now?
No, good. Still proud to say... Still proud to the best.
It's a holiday.
Proud to say that you came to Barrel Hill?
Yeah. I like the country towns. Always have liked the country. It's good.
Any plans of moving away? Or?
No, not this place.
No. And is this
a local wife would like too, I think.
Right.
Yep.
What would you like to do, dear?
Told you, move to Tasmania.
Tasmania. Only because it's cool.
Away from the family.
Yeah. Oh, the family.
We're all a family problem at the moment.
Yeah.
Never mind. Not a liar.
Fair enough. Who have we got over this side?
Oh, thank you.
Oh.
Have a guess.
Stinky.
Who?
I remember Stinky from year 7. My first year at Barrel Hill. No, it wasn't. That'd be 1980. You guys started in 1980?
1979, wasn't it?
1979.
Can I be rude and ask you your name?
Yeah, Mark Paul.
Yes. Okay.
That's it.
Okay. Now I remember having an English class.
Then.
Yeah, I certainly have. But it's all a rap dance.
Is it? That's
yeah.
That's pretty cool. Can you give us a demo?
A little laid perhaps on the floor. This is
Donald
French. Donald Hurd. Yeah, Donald. If I take you back to a room, it was near the teacher's loo, and we had English there. Donald, we used to. I can remember basically walking out and going back to the English staff room because of the antics of Donald. Donald was one of those sort of key stirrers. He'd just start things up and walk away from it. The class would be an absolute uproar. That's dead set my best memory of Donald Earth.
Still goes.
Today I'm trying to go to work, it's just stirring everybody up.
Must be a twin mate.
Yeah, that's yeah. What it is, isn't
it? Yeah. What have you done with this? When you said doctor?
Boilermaker, got my own business.
You work for Joy at all? Stay away from the miners?
I'm in a quarry.
No,
I work in a quarry now. Out of extra. Got married and had two kids.
This is the wife, yeah?
That's the wife.
This is the wife.
Thank you.
Well, how was that summary of Donald?
Interesting. No, that's true.
Actually,
he's still a stirrer.
Is he? Well, I mean, he could do it clean, you know. He never looked guilty.
Oh, he'd get away with it.
Yeah, every time.
You have to. That's it. And that's the thing, looking guilty.
You still local? You live in?
Yeah, I live in Mossvale.
Right. Okay. And this reunion, give you some fears about coming back and meeting up with people?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Who do you reckon's changed most if you look around?
Oh, there's a lot that's changed. Lot seems older. A lot older.
Well, you don't look all that...
He looks young.
I mean, you're a spring chicken, Donald, compared to some.
That's what I mean.
You look a lot. You used to look. You don't look a day older than you were. Yeah. You really look good.
Keeping your years very well.
Same.
Listen, which of the teachers, well, now we've got into flattery, any teachers that you still remember from that?
Brokershire. I remember Brokershire when he...
All right.
Oh, yeah. Science.
Oh, yeah.
What, he busted you a few times, did he?
Oh, yeah. I put a safety pin on the chair of Stephen Holtz.
Did you? Oh, big blonde Stephen Holtz.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
Stephen sat on it. I got four.
Well, Jim's still at the school, Jim Brokershire. Still the English, the science head.
Yeah. Oh, Carly. I remember Carly.
Yeah, Carly's still around.
Yeah. He was a top teacher, Carly.
He was.
All right. Well, I'll keep moving on.
All right.
Nice to meet you, Donald. And revive some old memories.
Yeah, not right.
Oh, God.
I've been working on you out the window a few times, mate. I'll tell you that. This table, it's old memories. The old people.
The old
guys. This is 11 years out of high school. This guy Cunningham.
Yep.
I can still remember Guy. Who else?
Carolyn.
O'Connor.
Now Cunningham.
Now Cunningham. Oh, dude, sir. Yeah, but this wasn't going on at school, was it?
No, he's here ahead of me. I didn't like him.
Right. You didn't like him? Couldn't stand. Well, what changed your opinion?
I broke his leg.
You broke his leg? And you had him laid up there? Oh, well. There must be a story attached to that. How did you break it?
Tell a story.
Fell on it.
Tell a story.
What did you do? Fell on it?
Fell on it while I was skating.
Tracy Mockins, the boot partner. I was Tracy Mockins, the boot partner.
Right.
We went roller skating. I couldn't roll skate, Carolyn couldn't roll skate.
Yeah.
So he grabbed me a jumper.
Right.
I fell over. I broke my leg.
Because I fell on it.
That makes an interesting story.
Then he couldn't run a baby class.
And how are you going? You got kids on your...
Two kids.
Two boys.
Boy and a girl?
No, two boys.
Two boys. And how old are they these days?
2.5 and 7 or 8 months.
7 or 8 months. Well done. And you still live locally or are you away?
Tathra.
Down the south coast.
Oh, Tathra south. Right, I'm thinking.
Bega, Marimbula.
Right.
Yeah.
What are you doing, Guy?
Greenkeeper. Yeah.
On which course is it?
Tathra Beach Bowling Club.
Right. Good.
Having a ball.
Having a ball?
Yeah.
Okay. Who else can we get to know here? Who else is off the call? Jackie. This is Jackie.
Yeah, Lemmy.
Lemmy.
Yes.
All right, we've got to get him close.
Oh,
come on, Jackie.
No.
What have you done with yourself, Jackie? Is yourself married?
No.
No? Still single?
No, engaged.
Engaged. And this is to be?
This is a prospective.
Prospective. Pleased to meet you.
Okay. That one.
No, well, what's happened in 10 years? 11 years,
what's
actually.
Yeah. Not much. Got a house in Mossvale.
Right.
Got a cat, no kids. That's about it.
Okay, Jackie, what are your, some of your memories? Which teachers still haunt your memories?
Nobody.
Is there, if you want to meet a teacher tonight, which teacher would be?
Sorry?
Which teacher would you want to meet tonight?
Nobody.
No. Totally unimpressed with the teaching staff about it.
Oh, no, I just wouldn't really want to meet them, no.
So they aren't asked. Yeah.
Now, this is Craig over here.
This is Craig.
Craig Edwards.
Craig Edwards. Okay. And what's happened to you, Craig, over 10 years?
Oh, I live out at Young now.
It's Young?
Yeah. My wife, Kelly.
Pleased to meet you. Right. And Craig, you've got a farm or?
Manager property out there.
Out there? Yep. Cherries or?
Sheep. Sheep and cattle.
Right. I thought everything out there was sheep.
We're a bit west of that.
A bit west of the cherries.
Right. Yes.
And what got you into farming? You?
That's what I wanted to do. Right. Left school and went straight out there.
Straight onto the farm. Did you do any courses at college? Yanko?
Yanko. Straight out onto the place and been there ever since.
And you're just managing the place or is it your own?
No, I just manage the place.
Right. Got your eyes set on buying something up?
No, I don't think so, no.
Is it good money managing a farm?
If we could buy one, it'd be better.
Yeah. Well, some of those properties further out west are selling up for almost a song, aren't they?
They are, yeah. You know. Yep.
I've got some friends in Tumut that have bought a property out the other side of Griffith. You know, it was ridiculous. Yeah. Just how cheap it was going.
Yeah, no, it was just, yeah.
All right, got any teachers that you remember from your time?
Teachers?
Yeah. What are the guys that are here?
There was that mad science teacher we had.
Which one?
Irish bloke.
Oh, Mr. Conlon.
Yeah.
Well, he's still there. He's still there.
He's still there.
Yeah. Still hit kids over the head or what?
Well, he's actually been put on a few charges.
Has he?
Good. Yeah.
I remember
him. Yeah. Do you?
Yeah, like, Mr. Man Wearing.
Mr. Man Wearing is about to retire. This will be his last year, I think, to be teaching. But here's something for you. Guy, you were talking about Mrs. Smith, was it?
I met Mrs. Street.
Mrs. Street.
She was a bit like Tom.
Well, she actually retired. She had bad vision. Yeah. Her eyes gave way.
Yeah.
But her husband, Neville, went over to Goulburn and became principal over there, and he's retired since. So they still live up on the hill there.
I got Smith and Street mixed up.
Did you? But here's the big news. Mrs. Smith has retired. Believe it or not. New library, and she retires.
Yeah.
Amazing. Anyway. Any other memories?
I feel like that.
What about the guys here? Who's the most changed person that you've got here?
Philip Howard.
Philip Howard? Big Howie. He hasn't changed. He was always a prop kid.
His hair's got a bit longer.
Yeah, it has.
He always had a crew cut.
That's true. I've actually, there he is now. I can just zoom over and catch him. I mean, he looks like, here he comes. I've got to catch up with him. He's definitely out there on his own. Bailey?
Yeah.
Okay. Righto. Yeah, we're rolling.
Hey, Ian. What would you like to ask me?
Okay.
I do this all the time.
I
like it.
Yeah.
I do. I'm really shy.
And this is Brother Bailey.
Hello.
Hello,
I'm Brother David.
Brother David.
And I'm very spiritual.
Very spiritual.
Very spiritual.
Brother David and Brother Matthew.
And my self-esteem's lacking.
Is it?
Yes.
Okay. Listen, we might just run this story past.
Yeah, right.
How did you get into this place tonight? Was there a controversy at the door?
Could have been. There could have been, but there wasn't.
Wasn't?
No.
Right.
No, I think we've all settled that we're getting older.
Right.
And we're maturing.
Indeed.
I hope we are. I really do.
Indeed.
I really hope we are.
Right.
We're growing up.
You were saying that you've had some experience with video cameras. You're a buff?
No, what I do is I like to catch people being natural.
Being natural.
To the camera.
Yeah.
But I can't do it for myself. This is the first time I've been taken.
Right.
But, you know, I don't mind catching other people. I like to be in the position you're in.
It's a driver's seat. It's a driver's seat. I love the driver's seat.
I like the driver's seat. I feel more comfortable in the driver's seat.
Maybe he learned that from you. Maybe he learned that from you in his short years together.
Indeed.
He's very nervous around the camera. I get very shy.
You get very shy?
I have to cover up.
Guys, that's a Cobra, too.
Yeah.
Cobra.
A Cobra.
Now, apparently, we've got got a big band on tonight. It's Jeff Deacon.
They play, but they're going to play some.
Jeff Deacon and who else?
And who else? Well, some brothers in hell. Darren and Brother.
Sounds familiar.
How do you think we're shaped up?
I reckon you guys look tip top.
We look tip top.
Yeah,
indeed. We're doing alright.
Yeah. What have you done with yourself, David?
I buy and sell motorbikes. I restore old motorbikes.
Yeah, restore old motorbikes.
And I've got married to this beautiful woman.
Yes, married his lovely wife. Hello.
Top wife.
Yes, top wife of a happy little child.
Happy little child, right?
Yes, but we have to work for it, you know, healthy sort of thing. You know.
And listen, where do you do the restoration of bikes? Is it local or
at home?
At home.
Home business.
Home business. Best way to go.
Yes, live on 18 acres out in the country.
Out in the country. How far? Which way are we going?
Not very far at all. Only from here to Buxton.
Buxton, right.
Yeah. Travelled all over Australia a couple of times. Right. Thought I'd better come back down to the cold climate.
Yes. But, you know, can't get it out of your system, can you?
Well, I like the hot climate, but I've come back to the cold climate.
Right.
Life's
where did you find your wife? This is the next best question.
Is it a wife?
Just wondering if it's a facto.
No, de facto. Marriage has been very good to us.
Sure.
Marriage is excellent.
Right. And how do you live with the fact that a Harley may be closer to his heart than you?
It's a Norton, actually.
It's a Norton.
We don't
sorry.
Like that. Harley Davidsons are for sheep. We sort of go for the more individual sort of thing, you know? Yes. Well, you actually, I think you remember that me and Matt were never like the rest of them, like sheep.
No.
No, we always.
You guys cut your own course through high school.
We did. We did.
Even this camera's having trouble keeping in focus.
Have you guys got a history? We have.
Police history.
His police history.
Yes.
I'm clean.
Clean?
Clean. I don't drink. I don't even smoke cigarettes. I am healthy.
Look at that lung capacity.
Very healthy.
You
are a passive smoker.
Actually, I'm a passive smoker. My wife smokes.
Oh, right.
And this is one of those current issues you work through in a marriage.
Yeah.
It's one of those ones that if boss is going to happen.
It goes in there and it comes out here.
Okay. Well, listen, the band's going to start, so I'll catch some of the band. I'll come back.
Catch the band. Make sure you do, because I'm a camera shot.
I want a good story
from
you guys.
If you ask some good questions, you work some thinking questions out.
Andrew Erskine, what does he mean to you?
I don't know who the fuck who he is.
Yeah. To the Muppets.
You do things like the Muppets.
Yeah.
You guys are out there.
We do Sail of the Century.
That's it.
Yeah. And the Bill.
What a repertoire.
What a repertoire. And how are you, Dennis?
I'm really good. I'm not here to talk
to you. Oh, that's right. 10 years later. And that's
memories.
It.
Some memories. Any memories flood back as you look around the place? With faces?
Yeah. I nearly wanted to cry.
Did you?
But then I threw up instead.
Alright. The people are responsible. Come on, John, you can tell us the whole story now.
For being thrown out of school.
Being thrown out of school, right.
Who was responsible? Who was responsible for your... Come on, you can
Mrs.
tell us...
Mr. Ciaccarelli?
Ciaccarelli was behind it, yeah.
What was that science one?
Conlon.
Mr. Conlon. Yeah. Mr. Conlon. And Mr. Street.
Mr. Street, was it?
Yeah.
And what was the reason?
Because I was never there.
Now listen, you've got to tell me, how many kids have you got there?
I've got three kids. Right. Three daughters. Right. 7, 2.5 and 2 months.
Listen, tell me, some people are going to be very surprised about who you married. Who did you get married to?
Apprenticeship on carpenter now. I work at Oxford Timbers and Barrel. And I'm in the bikes there, motorbikes.
Oh, you're joking. What size?
1100.
1100.
Yeah, I got a Yamaha 1100 and I got a KX250 trial bike.
Right.
And I got a XFU.
Yes.
Yeah.
Alright, married?
No, not married, single, just split up, but that's life.
And listen, there's something famous about you. You've got a cousin apparently in Sydney's football.
Yeah, Jeff Toovey. Jeff
Toovey.
Manly halfback, yeah.
Dead set.
Yeah.
And how come none of that sort of rugby league magic brushed off?
Probably didn't brush off me. Probably brushed off my older brother, Dow.
Alright.
But, yeah. That's life.
Okay.
I got out. We won a couple of premierships from Mittagong.
All right.
But other than that, I got out. I'm 27 now. I got out when I was 25.
Before it did major. You didn't have a major reconstruction, did you?
No, I'm not.
Well, there you go.
No broken bones. So I got out after won a couple of premierships.
What position did you play there?
I used to play second row.
Right. And did you take away best and fairest or anything silly? Or?
Yeah, I took out most improved player in 1989.
Oh, but you know what most improved means? Thanks for coming.
Coming, yeah. Yeah, you could say that, yeah.
Well, listen, what are your memories of school? You got any good ones?
Memories at school. Mr. Bysutti, science teacher.
Yeah.
I've got a couple of memories.
Yeah.
Mr. Bysutti,
yeah.
The old Garbo bus, Remick bus.
Yeah, right.
It was 30 years. Danny Cook, remember all them?
Yeah.
Leon Spicer,
yeah.
Paul Randall, yes. Robert Lynette.
Yeah.
All them were on the back.
Troublemakers. Yeah. They should have been convicts.
Yeah. Yes, well, one of them's convict now. Rob Lynette is in jail now.
Alright.
Yeah. I don't know where the others are. Peter's
net. Alright.
Yeah, Peter's mate, he's in Campbelltown. He couldn't make it.
Yeah.
Leon Spicer, Danny Cook, they live in Canberra, but I couldn't get on to them.
Right.
And, but this story, we left school one day.
Yeah.
And whole bus full of gubbos, mate.
Yeah.
And Mr. Bysutti pulled up beside us.
It's,
and one of the gubbos in the back seat knew what his name was. Mario.
All right.
I think that was his name, wasn't it? Mario?
Yeah. It's Mario.
This young gubbo kid, I can't remember who it was now, stuck his head out the window and said, "Hey, Mario."
It's
it. Well, he pulled the bus over.
Yeah.
Pulled the bus over. Talked to the bus driver.
Yeah.
He led him up the back of the bus, grabbed this kid, bumped him in the roof about 5 times. Bang, bang, bang. No.
Yeah.
Bang, 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 bang. Sat him down, the kid saw stars.
Yeah.
He said, "After school, don't call me by my first name." He said, "My last name is
Bysutti.
Bysutti.
Yeah.
Don't ever call me by my first name." He walked off the bus, we were all shocked.
Jed said, "Mate, was he really a stand-in for that guy, you know, that Schwarzenegger, do you think?"
Bysutti?
Yeah. Mario Biasotti Schwarzenegger.
No, he's a big boy. Yeah, I got told he's got some sons who went through there not long ago, and they're big too, were they?
They're all big.
Yeah.
Mark is near 11 now, and he looks a spitter for Mario.
Yeah.
He's got John and Matthew, and they're equally as big, but not as broad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, well,
Any other teachers that you remember?
Yeah, I remember the old bloke used to be in the metal work. Mr. Steele, wasn't it? Mr.
Hilton? No.
No, he was in there. He was in the, Mr. Reed.
Yeah.
Mr. Reed. I remember Mr. Reed. I got in trouble once. He was throwing stuff around the classroom and he walked in.
You, Neil?
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah, year
You're
eight.
An angel.
Year eight, yeah. Well, angel in disguise.
Yeah.
And he caught me and I got three cuts off him. I remember they were the three hardest cuts I ever got in my whole life. Yeah.
An old guy.
He was a good cane, that bloke.
Yeah. Maybe it was the shocks that he had in them, like the metal strips.
Yeah. Well, I think I don't mind those days, but this one. These days, kids get away with murder, and the teachers can't do nothing.
Well, we talked to them. I mean, if Mario did what he did to that kid,
these days
he'd be in court.
Yeah, be in court. Yeah, that's right. In those days, we still respect him. You know, we stepped out of line. We got a good
flogging. Well, you got a slap in the face.
That's right.
You said, yeah, I respect the guy.
That's right. These days, kids, you know, just unbelievable. Same in the homes. The systems in the homes. I went there the other day out of Remerick.
Yeah.
I was off to a job there, youth worker.
Right.
I wouldn't last there one day. I'll probably end up sitting a kid on his backside.
Yeah.
Just the way I was brought up, the way they're brought up these days.
Two different things.
I couldn't handle it. I've seen a lot of people here tonight.
Listen, who's changed most? Who do you reckon's changed most out of this bulk?
Ian Armstrong. I had to look twice at him.
Is he?
Yeah, he's around here. You've got to look twice.
Right.
You've got to
catch up with him.
Yeah.
And anyone else that you've seen that's changed?
Howie.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I've talked to Howie.
Yeah, it's like he's just dropped two bodies off him and got his own self now.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, Howie Hawley. I was talking about him. Hawley, yeah. Hawley. Chinese boy.
All right. Yes, he
has. He's lost a lot of weight.
Yeah, well, I was sitting next to him and I didn't know it was Hawley.
It's pretty hard to say. You see a few faces that have changed, but you know a lot of faces that haven't.
Yeah.
Like Jackie Fleming, Richard Bunner.
Yeah.
Richard Bunner's still the same.
Oh, he's a yak, isn't he?
Yeah, he's a Sphinx the Muscle.
Yeah.
That's arsehole in Dutch.
Where's it that you say?
Richard Bunner.
Richard Bunner,
yeah, he still hasn't changed. I've never really seen eye to eye to him, but life goes on and I start respecting him. I saw him the night in his hand.
Yeah.
But see, I'm going to go on a bit more here, you don't mind?
No, go.
When I was at high school, Barrow High, there was about a quarter of us gubbos in the homes, and there was a bunch.
Was it getting political?
No, there was a bunch of Barrow, Howard, Hawley, Brownie and all them,
yeah.
And we always had that friction between each other, you know, who was better than each other,
right.
But we never really sorted it out, but it doesn't worry me.
Yeah,
because
you guys knew you were the best.
Well, we didn't know, we can't say we were the best, but we're just saying that, we had respect for each other, you know,
right.
And we didn't bother having any problems or troubles.
Right.
But I was a bit worried about coming in and I thought I would have been the only one from the homes.
All right.
I came in, but there's someone else too.
Who was that? Who's he?
Andrew McCormack, Spud.
Spud.
He's still around. Him and I are the only two from Remerick in that year. So,
well, you shouldn't even think about it as being gubbos or whatever.
That was our nickname.
Yeah.
You were called gubbos. It doesn't worry me. I laugh at him now, you know.
But
there's a lot of people here tonight that I really enjoy. I just haven't seen them lately. I better call
them. People over here laughing at us.
Luke?
Yeah.
Donald Hurd?
And Donald, I've already talked to them.
Their wives and that. Yeah. But I better cut it short. Better cut it short.
I'll vote for you, Neil.
Yeah.
That's it.
Oh, that's good. That's good.
If you don't know me, my real name was Andrew McCormack. Like Neil, I was a gubbo. I think probably the best. One of the best memories I had in high school was doing Year 11 with Mr. Moriarty. Didn't do any maths, just talked about people we knew. All the fights I got doing the science lab. The trouble I got into with the principal. What else did I do? Of course, problems left, right and centre, I think.
Apparently you had Mr. Allen for the comments.
Yeah, Mr. Allen, yeah, he was interesting bloke. Did nothing but show his videos. There's slides of his trip to Canada. Never passed Converse and anything, did I? I think I passed Converse, but only just. But it made Converse interested.
What have you done with yourself, Andrew?
Me? Yeah. Oh, let's see. I've gone from here, I've gone to work for the railways, I've worked for Ghost Brothers, I'm now a retail manager at BBC Hardware.
Alright.
I run a hardware store, one of the bigger ones in the city.
Right.
I volunteer as a volunteer at the North Rock Deaf and Blind Centre for deaf kids. Because I'm deaf, so I help those kids.
Now listen, you've got an older or younger sister before me?
We've got two older sisters.
Two older sisters, right. Because I remember, was it Debbie?
Deborah Ruth.
Deborah, yeah.
4 years older than me. She went through and did year 12, and then a man, Leanne,
right,
who did year 10. She still lives in the area,
right,
as far as I know.
Right.
Could have moved again for all I know.
Right.
She's got a little boy now, so.
Right. What are your memories of high school? Are they good memories?
What are memories of high school?
Yeah. Are they good or bad? I mean,
a bit of a mixed bunch.
Yeah.
I was always an outsider, always a different.
Right.
A lot like Melanie Travers is not here tonight.
Alright.
Which is a shame, because she's become a doctor.
Has she?
Yeah, medical doctor. Or end of somebody else who knows, is it?
Right.
They weren't too bad. I had good and bad memories.
Right.
Most of the time I enjoyed going to school, gave me something to do.
Good, huh?
Gave me something to do between weekends, which I didn't like. But able to get on with anyone, that was nothing unusual.
Now listen, if we were looking for a deal on any hardware items, where do we find you?
Unless you want to drive the Hornsby, don't bother.
Okay.
And I don't think I'm going to be there much longer either.
Right.
I'm giving it away at the end of this year.
Right.
The business is not going too well.
Right.
Store is probably going to close, so I'm going to try and give it up and go into corrective services, or maybe go into community services, work with kids.
Right.
And go back into the homes where I came from and help those kids.
Help them out.
Yeah. Right. Something interesting to do.
Good talking to you, Andrew.
Okay. Good talking to you. I'm never going to live that name down.
No, I don't think so, mate.
I think all my teachers called me that too.
Yeah.
Not one teacher ever called me Andrew. Unless I was in trouble.
So, is the Brains Trust behind this reunion? Is this the
This isn't the Brains.
The Brains Trust behind the reunion is Judy Nolan.
Yeah.
Nee Milbank now.
And Nee Milbank. And Michael Hall. And Jeffrey Deacon.
And Karen DeVere also had a bit of a go in there too.
Yeah.
And Megan Painter. Remember Megan Painter?
She's got two kids, still skinny.
So, is this the man that used to spy on us smoking, John, do you think?
With
the camera?
With the camera.
Yeah.
We've got surveillance cameras now.
Dennis Agapur.
Technology at Barrel Eye.
Right. And I wear Nicorette patches.
All right.
Because of this man. So the man that's got the video camera.
Right.
He drove us this way.
He's done a good job. Can I ask you something about the side effects of those nicotine patches, by the way?
I can't sleep. I have terrible erotic dreams.
Do you have vivid, colourful dreams?
Yeah, vivid, colourful dreams of Dennis Agapur's head in the sun.
Holy shit.
And
that is...
Oh, it's terrible.
No, it would be.
This man has thrown me.
Driven you?
Yeah. Let's change the subject. Who is going to win these awards? If we went for a most changed person, like...
Most changed person?
We could do that.
Contenders.
Who's all the nations?
Nominations are...
Donald Byrne,
yes.
Most changed.
Yeah.
He's changed.
Are you talking physically or mentally?
Physically, mentally, I'd say Jeff Deacon would have to come into consideration. Well, definite attitude change.
I tried to stay the same just to please you, bud.
Michael Hall.
Yes.
Yeah, Hall's done his bit for change.
He's settled down.
Yeah, and he's a policeman now. He's got to abide by the law. He's got to abide by the set of brakes.
He's got to brake so on.
Yeah.
So these days when you talk to Michael, you just
watch
your step.
You be careful in what you say.
What about the women?
The women.
Still some gorgeous women here tonight, I must say. I'm not being prejudiced, but
Lizzie Elliott
there goes
still
one now.
Lizzie Elliott's got it.
Yeah, still got it.
Yeah.
Here's a guy we should have on the video if you can pan around to him.
Who is this?
Year above.
Yes, year above.
Year above.
Okay, but this guy's a very bad.
Yeah. My brother was in this year. Do you remember this guy?
Yeah. This is Nick. This is Nick.
Sorry?
Nick or Mark?
Bill. And my brother was in this year, Mark and me.
Right.
I'm the older one, year above.
You're the year above?
I'm the year above.
And what did you think of this year as a year?
Oh, it was a good year. No, it was a lot of dead shits. You can edit that out, can't you?
Days.
Yeah. There's a lot of good guys turn this year.
Getting back to the women. The women that I reckon, to see the fish burn, has become very stylish.
Indeed. Yes. I mean, she's just about like the lowest lady.
Oh, yeah. Melissa Doherty hasn't changed. Still slim, even though she has one kid, yes. Especially after having two kids, is still pretty streamlined. Leanne Steed, still very good looking. A lot of the males, female friends are very good looking, considering my own. Megan, Roddy Munro's girlfriend.
John's a very interesting man.
John is a very interesting man. Come in. This is Matthew. Matthew.
Yeah, actually, you got it right. I got it right. I'm impressed.
Okay. Now listen, John, I don't know that you know anything about Matthew. You guys want to basically take me through. We're just talking about all the guys that have changed and not changed here. And John just run us through some of the girls that he thought were pretty.
Some nice girls.
Yeah. Any names you want to drop? Drop some names for us.
I've been there before.
You've been there before?
Yeah.
You can't help me, sir.
No, actually, all I can say is I'm very content with what I got. I'm a very happy man.
This is a happy man. This guy's still got eyes wandering around.
I don't even look.
No, it's just that I admire. I admire beauty.
Indeed.
Yeah. So do I.
I've become sort of an art critic over the years.
All right. Armchair art critic.
Yeah. And
can you believe this, Matthew?
I'm just summing it up.
Okay. Ask Michael. See if he confirms the same names as I do.
What I say is it's dangerous.
It is dangerous. Come over here.
I'm on the way.
Michael. Dennis has got a question.
Yes, Dennis. Now, Michael, among the girls that have really got the sort of, the look,
the look. Yeah, we're talking tonight.
He'd be ranking up there. Saying contenders.
We're talking about girls we went to school with.
Yeah. Oh, geez, we went to school with. Well, I have to say, Liz Elliott's never changed.
Liz Elliott, right,
spot on.
She hasn't changed. Still a good sort.
Jeff Duggan, the girls that haven't changed.
Well, Jeff Duggan's a good sort,
but haven't. Are still sorts.
Well, after you had your sex change.
Leanne Muddle. The sex change.
Jackie Fishburne.
Massive memories.
Jackie Fishburne.
I said Jackie Fishburne.
You can Jackie Fishburne. And play this back. Johnson always names.
Yeah. Already been on here.
Karen Muddle's still sweet.
Karen Muddle's still sweet. Karen Muddle's still sweet. Leanne Muddle's still sweet.
Right.
Who else?
Leanne Steed.
There's Karen Ryan.
Leanne Steed.
Yeah, they're all good blokes anyway, aren't they?
I've been to the edge and back.
Bill of the cutting edge.
Philip Howard looks nice with his hair.
He does. Yeah, but Harry's a rock singer now. That's acceptable.
He's the magic lunchbox.
That's right.
And Rex owned it.
I wanted to come and get on it.
Don't call Howie.
You've been on Man O' Man.
How are you, Liz?
Has she been on Man O' Man?
Yeah. Oh, I think so.
Yeah. Yeah. Wow. Man O' Man.
Liz Elliott.
We saw you on Man O' Man.
Come on down.
I was on Man O' Man. Hey! I was the stripper. That's when it closed down.
What have you got to say about
that? Money, actually.
Liz, you are these two guys.
Your name's Liz.
He's talking about you.
Oh, no.
Hey, Holmes.
Yeah. Hey, Holmes. Dennis asked us.
Who I ranked as the most.
Judy Nolan's not even thrown around.
Judy Nolan!
Judy Nolan!
Judy Nolan!
Judy Nolan!
Get off there! God, she can't contain herself!
He's had a sex change!
Wake up!
He's no longer here!
What's happening, Dennis?
Hey, agree. He's a great yeah. I agree with you.
You agree?
Okay, so who takes the ultimate prize? Who takes the gold medal?
The gold medal.
Well, Liz, congratulations. Yeah, you've won the gold medal.
Yes!
Yes!
What do I get? Geography.
Oh, no.
And then I left and
who's
I went to.
Which was that?
Oh, no, nobody's at school.
Right.
And then I went to Wagga at Charles Sturt University and did my Tibet there, right? Then I came back to Barrel and I went to Oxford College.
Oxford College?
Yeah, Barrel High's arrival.
Yes.
I worked there for 3.5 years and I absolutely loved it. And, oh,
how could you be so secure?
I know, I took Greg Searle's job.
Did you?
Yeah, which is really strange. And then I left in June last year and I went to America and I went there for 3 months.
US.
Then I travelled through Europe and around England and then I worked in England for 7 months as a special needs teacher.
So you've got that as a background. Is special needs your...
Special needs is what I want to do, learning support. So I'm doing my master's next year full time.
Oh, look at this.
At Wollongong University. I've been accepted, I'm going full time, and so I'm casual teaching at the moment.
You want to say something to Roland, he'll see this.
Oh, yes, absolutely. Roland Mantua, I was really hoping that you'd come because I just wanted to know what you're doing because I thought that you'd have such an exciting life.
He has. He's in Peru.
I heard. And I wish I had a note because I'm missing him.
But he's in ballet, isn't he?
No, he finished. Melanie said that he finished when they went in New Zealand or something. I don't know, Roland. Fill me in. December, she said you're going to be here, so...
Come around.
Yeah. Mum and Dad are still in the same spot, same phone number, all that kind of stuff, so ring them and they know where I am.
Get in touch.
Yes. Because I'd love to see you. Yay. Thank you. That's it.
Any memories? School.
Oh, yes. Jumping on Matthew Iannelli and techniques.
Yeah.
Spud, come on down, brother. You've been there and back. Let's go. Big hand! Big hand for Spud!
Thank you. What time to get these awards?
Thank you, yes. Few words from the Spud Monster. Spud's just flabbergasted. He doesn't know what to say. Go, Spud.
Suppose we've got to say something. I'm actually surprised anybody remembers me, because I didn't stand out at all. Probably explains why I was stuck in the Twilight Zone. Nobody knew where I belonged.
The Spud.
Blow it out your ass. Anyway, suppose I should say thanks, so thanks.
Come on.
I like to thank my mum, my dad, because it took two of them. No, I'm only joking. Look, all I can say is that if anybody has any property in Sydney to sell whatsoever, then give me a call. And if you need a business card, I'll be down the back corner. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Richard. I'm a digger.
Richard Bunter!
Biggest bullshit out of
Richard Bunter! Richard Bunter. Okay, the next on the agenda here. I'd just like to have a word here. This is beautiful, isn't it? 10 years, and everyone still looks the same. Except for Paul Delamont. He's got hair and stuff all over his face. I can't do that. But everyone still looks the same. Now, which brings me to the next award. The next award is, I haven't changed one bit. Mario Boisuti. Mario? No, he's not here. We've had a big decision on this. It took us a couple of seconds. The nominees are Seth Jurevic. The next one was Adam Vickery. We're starting off with this because he's lost a bit. He's lost a bit of control, man. Michelle Kavanagh. The two Bailey boys. Look at them, they're the same. And look at them. Hey, you blokes nearly won the Twilight Zone Award. Right? Stay cool. And I've got a long knee, long son. And the winner is... Sit in. Nah, you haven't won it, so you come up anyway. And the winner is...
Sydney!
Liz Elliott! Woo!
Sydney!
Liz Elliott, come on down. Come on down. Come on, Sydney.
Shit. I've got fuck all to say, and that's it.
Thanks for that, Matt.
I'd just like to thank Matt for them few
words. Is Liz Elliott going to come down?
Yeah, is that coming from Matt's heart?
Well, this is
down in the bottom of his jones at the moment.
Paul Delamont. A few words from Liz Elliott.
I haven't changed a bit, and so I've got nothing to say. Okay, thank you very much.
Phil Howard. We're gonna do a song for you now.
Count it in. See.
One, a two, a one, two, three, four.
It's funny you should talk, Ada. 10 years, and if anyone was going to die of lung cancer, it's Ada Smith and his story. He can't talk, he can't cough, but fuck, he's still here. Ada Smith. This is a number award for best reply received. What it was for the person who replied the best. And there was one reply, there was a tape, there was a check, sorry, it was taped up, it was put in post pack, and then it was taped up again and put into another post pack. Ada Smith, you are... everybody that by the time of year 9 he was the only person who'd broken 50 in the Kane Marks Award.
Look, what can I say? I was humiliated. People don't trust me, I don't know why. They say, I tell them all the time, the check's in the mail. Karen wouldn't believe me, I sent it in a bomb-proof package so I could get there. Thank you very much for this award. I thoroughly deserve it. And I leave you with it. What am I doing? Richard?
Thanks, Adam.
The next award we have is the I Haven't Changed a Bit Award. Well, tonight before I came here, I thought, I'm saying to myself, well, I don't think I've changed, but I hope no one else has. Anyway, to see everyone in the room tonight, no one's changed at all. Forgot a few names, but you nearly pick anyone. And the I Haven't Changed One Bit Award, there's nominees: Stephen Ford, Lisa Boggs, Darren Akers,
John Holmes.
Sorry, John Holmes can't be with us tonight about a bad accident and disease. But the winner was none of these nominees, and he's the person he hasn't changed over the years, he's still a shit stirrer, is Michael Hall.
Set up. But I have changed, haven't I? A little bit. Yeah, we'll just move on to the next award here. Okay. Now we're gonna do a little song for you. We've got the beat here. It's an oldie but a goodie. And here we go. A one, a two, a one, two, three, four. You don't have to be beautiful to turn on. I just want you. I'm not compatible with, I just want your extra time and your kiss. Yeah, see it now, we've got a Howie. Howie's on the, get what I mean? We'll do it again, one more time now. Box, Philip Howard.
The next award.
See, I have changed. I can sing now. Okay.
I'm going to have great pleasure in announcing this next award. It's actually for the most changed, okay? We've got a few nominees tonight, okay? We've got a few that have most changed the most. One of them is Adam Vickery! He's changed and aged. Big time.
See everybody. I didn't know who was going to not come tonight. Obviously, Chow and all those guys sort of missed the boat. it's fantastic to see anybody here tonight. I don't know if I got most changed, but anyway, I think that's up to the adjudication, which leaves a lot to be desired, at least. And if they stop pinching your bum. But anyway, it's good to see everybody here tonight, and I'd just like to say thanks very much, and everyone enjoy, because I am. Thanks very much.
Do you want to do a song, Darren? Everyone else has.
No, I don't think so.
Our last award for the evening is the most changed girl.
Very much.
So any of you blokes that don't get nominated, don't be offended. But for the most changed girl, we've got nominees.
Trevor Jones. Sorry, man.
Lisa Fox, Ray Lee, Roberts, Christina Fishburne,
and Timmy!
done something.
Dave McLaughlin. A few words from Jacinta. Yes. Neil Toovey, again, there he is. Neil Toovey. Go on, Jack. Jacinta.
It's nice to be here.
All right. This is a bit of boring shit, but apart from the shenanigans that have gone up here tonight, there's been 10 years since a lot of us have seen each other. Anyway, it's 10 years, so it's on behalf of myself and I know the other two guys up here, it's been lovely to see you all and catch up with you all and find out how everyone's going. But we should make it a rule that no one says, so what are you doing? Or what have you been doing?
Does anyone know what Howie's saying?
Where do you live? Because we live somewhere and we do shit. So, anyway, we all know that we do something and we all know we do somewhere. So let's cut the materialistic, metaphysical kind of quantum science and produce to the stage where we say, hey, it's really good to see you after 10 years, 8 years, 7 years, 4 years. You could be Asian, you could be Asian, you know. It's beautiful. You've changed. You were a policeman once. Now look at you. Anyway, I found my thrill on the radio. I found my fucking thrill.
We've got a few apologies tonight too, Jamie Dodd. She's blind, look at her, hammered, pissed out. We've got a few apologies tonight. Probably all of you remember Roland Van Til. Roland Van Til now works for the Australian Embassy in Paris. Hey, how's that? Leon Spicer, he couldn't make it. Robert Lynette had a previous engagement, he couldn't make it.
Scored 18 months in Long Bay. Hey, you know he was headed that way, we all know his. No one said anything, stop it, change your ways. We were young, sure, but we saw beyond the years, didn't we? Come on, think about it, in all those years we could have seen beyond that.
Well, that's just about it. We're going to put Jeff and the, what's the band called, Jeff? The Ultimate Freak Out. Jeff Deacon and the Ultimate Freak Out. Sorry? Oh, yes. And especially, big thanks. We've got a really big thanks to thank Megan Painter and Judy Nolan. I think they did a really marvellous job with this.
Karen Lovell.
And who?
Karen Lovell.
Oh, Shane Haylock couldn't make it. Poor old Shane. He's a...
Cholera. Yeah, that's cool.
He's modelling in the States.
Just on behalf before the band starts again, I'd like to say it's lovely to see you all. I thought I knew.
But I want to know for sure. Yeah.
kids. But I wanna know for sure. Come on, wild thing, you know how to make it move.
The last 10 years.
10 years?
Yeah.
I've been to Mount Albany, I've lost my
much. Moved down to Buxton, built a house in Buxton. Got married, started a family, got an upholstery business, room cover and lounges.
Oh, upholstery.
Yeah.
He's having Gorman's.
Sorry?
Gorman's?
Yeah, opposition.
He's got no hair.
This guy's going to have no balls.
No, I didn't have any balls to start with, mate, so it's not a problem.
It's not a problem, is it? What we've been saying is it's not only made of you.
I think
it's twins. Air on.
These guys are twins. From a good sex life.
All right, well, listen, just hold the camera. Let the camera say. Okay?
These guys.
Right, we're working out. These guys twins.
These guys look like twins.
That's the water here in Bowron.
Have these guys got no hair on, huh?
Okay.
This lead theory is probably a better question to ask with this hour today. What haven't I done that I'm not legendary at?
Yes.
Fishing!
Fishing! Yeah.
That's really fishing!
Right. I've never caught a fish,
you
mate.
You haven't got a shark or a rod backyard.
It's stolen property.
Insects!
Yeah. Got a tip for you. Yes. Use a condom, huh? Use a condom. Oh, try it.
We always do. Yeah. We swear by it.
And remember, the light at the end of the tunnel just might be a fucking train.
That's just the sort of blinking philistine pig ignorance we come to expect from those non-creative garbage. Sitting there on their lonesome spotty behind, squeezing blackheads, not caring a tinker's.
Severest tragedies that you have this year, what do you feel
the tragedy, there's no famous people amongst us,
yeah.
And there's no rich people.
Indeed.
But if there was rich people amongst us, millionaires and whatnot,
yeah.
They could have shouted us the whole evening, you know. Like, just I won a lot, but I'm not going to tell anyone.
Cousin. What's Kevin been up to?
Nate probably still playing with his cows.
Is he?
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah, we still milk cows. At least they won't place now. We're going pretty good. Yeah, it's going real well. That's all I've been doing since I left school. 10 years, milk cows.
Cows?
Yeah.
What do you reckon that, mate?
Mate, he must like his cows. That's all I can say.
Well, it's going to be dairy products. Still making money?
Yeah, it's money. As long as you do it right.
You married?
Yeah, married three kids.
You got your house paid for, I bet.
We leased the place, so the house comes with it. So. Money in the bank.
All of that. What
are
you
up to?
I've got my own business now in Canberra. Marketing, distribution.
Yeah.
Keeps me out of mischief.
Are you still married?
No, not married. Still single. Got a girlfriend.
Person who's most changed?
I don't know. There's a lot of people I haven't recognised.
Right.
But I don't know. You still, I more have hassles with names rather than faces.
Oh, right.
Faces, I can sort of say yes, I know them.
Yeah.
But names is a difficulty.
Have you kept up with anybody?
Not really, because I went to Canberra. Everybody else went to Sydney.
Right.
I went to uni down in Canberra.
Right.
And everybody else went to Sydney, so I lost track of most of them.
Who's the most unusual person you've met in an unusual place? Ever come across anybody?
Unusual person?
Well, just someone in the mall. Have you ever met a person in a different place where you wouldn't expect to find them?
Nothing comes to mind.
Okay, just a dumb question.
What was the question?
The question was, have you met up with anybody in a strange place? Down at the mall.
Anybody?
body under a tree.
Still remember?
Yep. The old robot. Man wearing, Alfie.
Yep.
By Soddy, Bigfoot.
Yeah, Mario.
Right. Who else? Stick Farron.
Stick Farron, right. Happy Stewart. Stewart Hawkins. Where's Stewart?
Yeah, Stewart. Stewart's still around. He's actually got kids going through year 11 and year 7 and yeah, all up in high school now.
Does that have to be thinking about it?
Yeah, he's always been there maybe 20 years now.
He was our foremaster. Yeah, one he's there tonight. Miss Loughlin, alright? She's the home science teacher.
Yeah,
never
she wasn't too bad.
What was her name?
Miss Loughlin, she was.
Miss Loughlin.
But she actually got married while we were there.
Yeah, she married one of the other teachers.
And he's a bike. Married to the bike.
Was she?
Yes.
Who's the teacher that you will never forget?
Taught me most of Dick Farron.
Dick Farron,
yeah.
And
probably Mr. Street, I suppose.
Yeah.
Last group was pretty.
Pam Carl.
Pam Carl.
Yeah, she was pretty good. I'm trying to think who else. There's trouble on camera.
Join you, boys.
That's alright.
Okay, listen, let's get a few questions answered. First, how did you get this sort of forest going here?
It's a cold weather defence.
Is it?
Yes.
So you're down in Canberra, aren't you?
No, I'm still in Barrel.
Are you?
Yes.
So what are you doing in Barrel?
Well, at the moment, this week I'm working for a security firm.
Are you? For the moment?
Yes.
Are you that?
Bit of a gigolo.
Gigolo,
yes. No. Yeah. An employment gigolo.
Right.
Beware the camera.
Yeah, someone's going to see this at some stage.
Exactly.
Gigolo, no, just take that out.
Right. That's right.
Send it home.
My wife knows what I'm like, it's alright.
Right.
Married 3 years now, no kids, two dogs.
Married.
Thank you very much.
Married with
no kids. Mm. Alright, so where are you, mate? Where is he? I don't know, is he on this planet?
Like a horse.
No.
He and Howie should be getting together, I think.
I have not reached the Howie stage.
No, there's Mars and there's Pluto, and even somewhere in between. Right. Yeah.
You've got Earth and Pluto. Howie's on Pluto, I'm on Earth.
Now listen, the last thing that I saw was something of a propaganda piece that you were running for, what was it, some party? Was it a national party that I think, was it the National or Liberal Party?
I shall never ever vote National.
Well, come on. Well, what was it that I...
Again.
What was it the Communist Party did?
Communist sounds right.
Who was he running?
I noticed there's a dash of red in this.
I'm proud to say that I am a member of the Liberal Party.
The Liberal Party. Oh, that's what it was indeed.
I am a member of the Liberal Party.
Right.
And I can...
He's been Liberal for some time now.
He has.
Oh, yes. Yes, you just see my body.
abusing his body.
Come on, then.
You've been in the... Camera! It was you, after all this time!
Yeah, I realised it was
me, the chook,
you.
And the bottle of fire. So listen, we're sending regards to Roland.
I've been lying there looking at these cameras, and I've been really... Who put the cameras there?
Typical politician.
Okay, listen, can you say something to Roland?
Yes. Hi, Roland. I hope you're having fun in Paris. Mm-hmm. You lucky bastard.
Yes, indeed. What do you think of Roland being a...
Roland, we never really knew each other, only to say that you were the better actor in Mr. Erskine's drama class.
You're giving
that
credit.
And for that, you have all my credit.
Mm. Well, you wouldn't give me credit, would you?
Mate, no, he's got a cash up front, everything's cash up front from me. No credit to anybody.
This guy's about as entrepreneurial as you can get.
What, you've changed?
Well, I'm not.
Actually, I haven't changed.
A heel.
Actually, I haven't changed.
Capitalist.
Well, I haven't changed, I've just become more myself than
Christopher Skase's lawyer
in
Australia. Indeed. What are you doing here? You should be in New York.
Lost my visa. Actually,
where's your wheelchair?
I've been talking about sort of individual memories from school.
Yeah.
And one sort of vivid memory I have at Roland is of all those guys making fun of him because he did ballet.
Yes.
However, in one PE class, we were doing some stretching exercises on the floor. Roland had his legs at 180 degrees and his chin on the floor. Yes. And every guy in the class was envious of him, and I thought, right. Good on you, Roland.
You've done it.
Got your own back. Good on your son.
Yeah. There's a memory for you, Roland. Any memories of Roland? No. You just didn't.
As to previously of what I said.
Yeah. Just rewind, Roland. You'll hear it again.
And again.
Yeah. Well, so has Beryl been good to you guys? Beryl Hall?
Beryl High wasn't bad, but...
Beryl High?
Beryl...
Yeah, come on. Yeah, you can be honest now.
Beryl High?
Did nothing for you, did
I can
you?
Remember one teacher that I had. Mm-hmm. History, I believe.
Right.
You're
going
11.
Back to high school, it would be history for you.
Yes. Year 11, 2 weeks only. Mm-hmm. Only 2 weeks in year 11, 1984. Mm-hmm. Name Dennis. Last name...
Oh, Kenny. Rhyme with something like...
Archipelago.
Arkansas.
Poor.
That's it.
Poor.
That's the one.
Mungle dog prick.
Yes.
Gee, I agree.
He left us. He left us and gave us Rod Smith.
Dead set.
I had bribed this asshole, Arkapoor, and could have sworn I got excellent marks in HSC.
Well, listen. The fact that you got good marks in the HSC goes to those 2 weeks, let's face it. Without them, you would have been lost. What do you think?
Well, I'm on the HSC, obviously that 2 weeks I just missed out on, right?
Goes without saying.
Right. Well, listen, Rod Smith's no longer been teaching that.
This is true. This is true, I actually got to him.
Did you?
He decided to work for a living.
thanks, Derek.
Boom, boom.
Alright, so how do we wind up, fellas? I mean, I'm going to run out of battery power if you guys.
We're running out of battery power.
Well, let's get down to significant things.
Significant things?
Do we have anything to say?
Vote Liberal.
Oh, God.
Blimey. Significant
this
things.
Guy's going off.
Beryl High wasn't bad. Beryl sucks. So I'm leaving and going to a sunny little place called Foster on the beach.
There you go.
Tourist?
I mean, he's a capitalist.
I'll be a local.
I can see what you're doing.
A house spouse. I've got a wife who works, earns big money.
Yeah?
4% interest rate on the mortgage.
Oh, here we go.
What? Yeah, Mr. Arkapoor, how are you?
Hey,
cheers, Rob, all the best.
Hey, come back.
Okay, well, thanks for the call.
They used to call Rob Munro Sharp for some reason.
They used to call Rob.
Actually, Sharp. The Sharper.
The Sharper.
Lots of shafts.
Is that Dandruff? Phil Wales?
That's Dandruff.
Ah, yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, Phil Wales.
Got something to say?
Philip Wales on a spit.
I just want someone to suck my dick.
This is getting...
We all like a meal, not a snack.
So we'll pass that.
Well, listen, then we've got some of the males of Beryl High here.
Males.
Just hanging out in the kitchen. Seth, we haven't met you formally on video.
Sister one!
Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen, a minute of silence for Seth.
For Seth.
Seth!
Take it back. It's 10 seconds.
That'll work.
That's about as much
time. Nice bowl haircut, Seth.
He feels just jealous, mate. He'll just
Jonas, you can't have a haircut like this. All the women that I do.
Actually, talking about hair, Adam Rabin.
Talking about
ladies and gentlemen. Adam Raymond.
That's Dennis's
twin.
Twins.
Twin
brother. No, okay. Separated at birth. They've got six stingers each.
We're catching up with Pete. Pete, what are you
doing? Cook us up a storm. What am I doing? I've lived. Cook us up a storm.
Yeah, lived in every state, yeah. Just about, except for what, Perth and so West tell Australia us, and
what have you been up to, mate?
Nice, Monroe.
Do you like spilling alcohol tissues? And just
you're interfering with the interview. Shut up.
Sorry, does the size of your penis worry you?
Yeah, it does. Hard working fingers.
So tell me, Sis, you and Ian Armstrong become quite close early on. What was that?
But I heard you down the window tonight, mate.
Is this a piece of your brain?
No, Sis, this is your life, mate.
Well, let's run it past him. First year out of school. What was he up to?
What happened? First year out of school, Sydney, motor mechanic. Second year out of school, Sydney, motor mechanic. Right. Third year.
Right.
Tassie, motor mechanic. Yeah. Fourth year, Tassie, motor mechanic.
And still the general one. Just worried you, eh?
Still, are you worried?
Yes, mate. Finish that. Right. Furniture industry now. Right. Selling. Traveling all over the
drugs.
World.
Drugs. Oh, right, Columbia.
Yeah.
Do you like the special buses?
Dad, do you like driving the special bus?
No. You're a motor mechanic, mate. You know what it's all about.
I think it's time we go on that. Cross Munro. Munro stop.
Okay, so first year out of school, right?
Greenkeeper.
I'm not going to comment on the ground.
Grass cutter.
Grass cutter. I like green things.
Heard a few stories about him chopping up.
Well, you're actually hoses.
No, no.
We did grab the.
And he doesn't like backpackers apparently.
Yeah, I love backpackers. I love backpackers.
Still a suspect for the backpacker murder.
Well, we like a few. Whilst he's actually got no hair either.
Hey,
show us your hair, Tyrant.
Come on, Greg Matthews can't be right.
He looks like Greg, doesn't he?
Like you were saying back in the 80s.
Yeah, back in the 80s.
Yeah, well, this time it was owing to the fact that one, he drives a combi.
Yeah.
Two, he lived 2 kilometres from Belanglo State Forest. And three, grew up in Gorscombe Gorge. Oh, I'm a smiley cover. Yeah, I'm a smiley. And plus he spray painted his combi. Yeah,
well, actually, let's stop this right here. Yes. I'd just like to point to this fella over here.
Hello.
Oh, yes, it's ringing. Great pressure.
Well,
a girl.
This guy hasn't got a problem with the size of his penis.
No.
Because he shows everyone.
Hey, I'm a girl.
I rest my case.
We haven't got a wide angle left.
Yeah.
If I could just take over here for a minute, yes, I am a ringing.
Yes.
Yes, I have crushed your party. Yes. And yes, I am having a good time.
Yes, and he's a funny man.
Fucking funny man.
My funny, right?
Look at his head. Look, now let's zoom in on this. Zoom on the head.
Do you have mirrors at your places?
That really hurt.
That really hurt.
Nice seeing you guys.
Okay.
See you in 10 years, huh?
See you in 10 years.
Peace, yeah. Love.
Sex and drugs.
Yeah.
Here's a tip.
Barrel high.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, we fucked them.
And it's good night for me, and it's good night for me.
Right.
Barrel high for you.
Oh, God. The fight between Leanna Simpson and Jane Warden in the Girls' Loop.
I remember the science block.
Yeah. Everybody was there. They were climbing all up and hanging over the.
Oh, was Lydia. Train.
And you were in it?
I was just spectating.
Lydia.
Lydia
Henshaw.
And I was there.
Right, you were there.
Yeah, and I remember.
But I'll let Leanne.
Oh, that's like, I just remember everyone hanging out at the edge and the girls walked in and they took their shoes off, and there'd be no cat fight and all this, and that was just on.
Oh, it was huge.
It was packed. It was vicious.
John borrowed somebody's
Right, mate, what's your fondest memory of Barrow Island?
Oh, the thing that sticks in your mind the most?
There are many. I remember Sharon Barnes always wanted to fight me. Yes. Eventually she did, and I won.
To a pole?
Sharon Barnes was a lesbian.
She punched me and I beat her nuts.
Sharon Barnes is a lesbian now. She's built like two brick shit house. She's huge.
So you can take on Sharon Barnes now.
She's in a totally different circle to me, so we would never collide.
But then,
I think I wouldn't know.
So you girls remember fights? Gee, that makes Barrow sound like a rough house.
It was.
It was a jungle.
Your history class, you must remember. The girls were the most outspoken.
He wasn't. You didn't teach us, did you?
Year 11 history.
Yeah. Ian was telling me he only had me for about 2 weeks. And then I wanted him for life.
Right, Karen. What's your...
Mine.
Your most...
Mine...
be a fight.
Do you have to get so close? mine is a fight, but if you don't want, I can... The fight was Raylene Robbins.
Raylene Robbins is here.
Yeah, she's here. Right, and Sharon Barnes was with Sharon Barnes.
Yes, I remember.
At PE or something, and Sharon took both of us on. It was so funny. Here's me trying to hit Sharon like... I was here, and Sharon was up here. And Raylene came running from the back and pounced, and she was on her back.
Just like that.
Yeah, she was climbing all over her back, and I'll never forget that. Actually, I was laughing about that the other day. But besides fights, can we think of anything that we've done?
Anything good?
Any achievements?
I think the friends we had. I think there were some people there that we will never forget.
Yes.
And I think we were all pretty honoured and lucky to know people like Michael Hall.
He's
a legend here.
Michael Hall.
He's here.
Yeah. A legend.
He's a legend.
Most memorable. Did you used to walk through Westwood with us?
Yes.
And the log. Remember the log? Well, there was quite a few things that went on through Westwood.
Dave Prentice, and he only really got me because all my hairs were cut to pieces.
Sam
was on the wall and he got us.
That was incredible.
I felt like I was in New York, you know.
You remember that?
Well, I do. I remember the fact that I got told after the event. Couldn't believe it was John Stewart.
I think Westwood holds more memories for most of us.
One of my fondest memories
were
Mr. Worrell. Woodwork one day, and old Flicky said to me, I have my shirt buttoned down on. And old Flicky said to me, Mr. Stewart, he said, would you mind buttoning up your shirt? He said, until you got hairs on your chest. And I turned around and I said to him, Mr. Worrell, I said, well, don't you flick your hair across until you got hairs on your head. He said, outside.
You don't talk to more people like that.
You know what I did to him then?
No.
Yes. I jumped through the window and I welded the door together with the oxygen welder with the catapult. Jumped back out the window and ran around, stand there and you couldn't open the door.
We can open it.
So when he finally got the door up, he had a T-square and he used to walk past the T-square and back on that. I got in and I put a nail through the middle of it.
Right.
So he raced his shoulder and ripped his arm off. He turned around and he said, I know you did it, he said, but I've got to prove it.
What about Chocorelli?
What about the Mr. Chocorelli's little back room?
He did take us in the back room and he did really show us something, but not...
I got Chocorelli back. Chocorelli got stuck into me because the Barton boys reckon I ripped their canoe off, yeah. Which I did. But
what an honest guy you are, John.
Profession, yeah. Yeah.
So, John really was always saying, take the chuck out of the drill near the window.
Yeah.
So he get stuck into me, so I thought, I'll fix you, you bastard. So I put the chuck key in the drill and I turned her on. She went straight through the window. So I blamed it on the Barton boys.
This guy?
This guy is amazing.
Yeah, hasn't like hasn't half the things that went wrong in that school come
was
back.
Was John.
Yeah,
half
the
yeah. But then there was the serious times when I played Shakespeare and Mr. Erskine.
Yes.
Remember,
our English teacher, did you? I see Mrs. Jeffries in the post office the other day.
Yeah.
And she was on Friday, and I was telling her about tonight, and you know, and I said, oh, it makes me feel old. And she said, well, how old are you? And I told her, and she, you know what she said to me? Shocked me.
Yeah.
I don't know if I should say the word. Oh. She said, well, I'm fucking 66.
True.
Miss Jeffries.
Wow.
I couldn't
she's
believe it.
She's a legend.
Remember the play we did with Miss Carl? Miss Carl?
She's another legend.
Yeah, that Sherlock Holmes play.
I haven't been none
of I remember the Shakespeare one.
Yeah.
Yeah, drama class was the first, but there was scary stuff.
Yeah, alright guys, I'm giving the battery sign, which means wind up. Which basically means...
Close it up.
It's
really great to be here and
we came to school,
we disbelieved, yes.
Disbelieved.
And would say in another 10 years,
will we?
Definitely.
We'll be back.
I think we should take one little picture of the man.
No, well, I've already been on there. That's and all right. I want to say is, gee, it's
we're
horrible on this side. Oh, this year.
This is the best
sound
you've
this year.
Been to.
Yeah, I don't know what
I'd
say, man. On the record.
That I received from you.
What did I say, man?
Come on, you haven't got much time, girls. Get in there, man. Yeah.
Really?
Right. Dad always has an excuse.
If Mr. White thought he ever sees this, he had no right in giving me D on my
thing.
He told me that if everybody done their homework, they'd get no less than a B. I always done my homework, and their mum gave me a D. So if you're looking,
I reckon Mr. Bysuddy's a pillow biter anyway, so.
And Mr. Bysuddy, just because my sister couldn't do chemistry, doesn't mean I had exactly the same problem.
We were in his science class, and if you ever wondered what it was we were doing right in the back table, we not only had Chinese food, hot chips and everything else, but we had a ball, we had candy drink in the movie.
She's gone.
So there you go. If you wonder what we were
doing. Chinese food.
Yeah, we used to go down, we had one special day, the last science class, we went down the street, we bought all this food. We used to always eat this. We didn't listen to you, that's probably why you gave me.
Stuart Carlisle sneezed and the whole class wore it.
And Mr. Bysuddy, I'm sure, still has nightmares about it.
Well, I hope he does.
You're out here. Thanks for finishing.
Just come back from New Zealand. I'm not going to blink. I know you think, oh, I just blinked. Oops. Mistake, we'll have to cut. Okay. No, it's all right. But we'll keep going. We're at our 10-year reunion. I've just been told I've got to wrap this reunion up. Whoops. That's better. Oh, thank you.
He's getting nervous.
Right, hard starter.
Now you got your petrol.
I don't know, Chris, that's a fart.
Okay.
No,
thanks, Elliot.
Yep, this is the end. This is it.
This is
finished.
No more.
See, hang on, 10 years' time.
Maybe
see
again.
You then. Hopefully.
Maybe again.
If I'm still alive, I'll be here.
All right.
And I expect everyone else to be as well. Okay?
Indeed. We'll just put it into fade and the last words. Kick me because I gave your sister's time. Listen, we started with Marion. Let's finish with Marion. We've had Elliot Goblet tell us that he's had a wonderful time. You had a wonderful time. Yeah. Wrap it up for us.
Wrap it up.
How's it up?
Yeah.
Yeah,
we're sorry, but that's all, folks.
Let Jeremy show, but where are you 10 sort of?
This is Dick Bunner.
Let me get in close, because this guy's Philip Brown, this guy's Jeff Deacon. Jeff Deacon's made...
Richard Bunner's looking for it again.
Yeah.
No, he is.
No, I'm not.
Oh, yeah. Biggest shit dribbler.
Right.
Oh, thanks.
Fuck you.
Out of high school, so probably the best year to get in there, because I made a lot of friends really quickly.
Right.
And that's mostly what I remember, all the friends that I made. Wasn't too active in the class department really at the time, right. but I got there eventually. And now I'll let Mr. Smith say something.
Well, year 10 was my third year of Arrow High. Likewise, met a lot of good people. Highlight of my time at Arrow High was Sports Day, which was held with Mr. Fishman.
We're not
particularly proficient in that. But our form overall was informed.
Yeah, who was your year master? Who was that?
That would have been Mr. Hawkins.
Stuart Hawkins.
Yeah, Stuart Hawkins. And I remember being in charge of the role and occasionally marking myself absent when I was there.
That's right, deliver the role back to
the rest of the day free. It was pretty good.
Check off on the absentee list, no worries whatsoever.
Now listen, yes. If this is going over to Roland Van Til, do you guys remember Roland Van Til at all?
We do. I remember Roland Van Til.
Roland Van Til.
What would you like to say to him?
I especially remember him in my art department. And I suppose we should say a big hello to Roland.
Yeah.
Hello Roland.
He probably takes that to heart.
Oh, he should do. He should do, because it's well meant.
Well meant.
All right. What do you think of the night?